Hello, welcome. For those following Yuzu Android, I've mentioned several times that the way the recompilers work was the app's weakest point, and that improving these recompilers could drastically change the app. Finally, the development team has brought this improvement, and today, we'll test and comment on the experience with Yuzu NCE. To help this video reach as many people as possible, don't forget to hit the like button. If you enjoy getting the latest updates firsthand, subscribe to the channel. Let's aim for 10,000 subscribers.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
Before showing the actual performance gain, let's talk a bit about the NCE project. As mentioned before, Yuzu used Windows recompilers when running its games. This meant that processes that were native to the Nintendo Switch's ARM platform were first compiled for the native Windows platform, and then compiled again for ARM. NCE, or Native Code Execution, speeds up this process significantly and requires much more modest hardware demands. Additionally, NCE reduces device heating during use. While recording this video, I observed no thermal throttling, making Yuzu the definitive solution for playing Nintendo Switch on your Android device. Combining NCE with the performance-optimized driver mentioned in a previous video, link available in the card. You can make some games run on devices with only 4 GB of RAM, such as a Redmi Note 8, for example. However, keep in mind that optimized drivers are currently available only for Snapdragon processors, and not all games will perform well with 4 or 6 GB of RAM. While preparing the script for this video, I noticed that the GitHub version where NCE was officially released is already available. I'll leave the link in the description of this video. To enable NCE, simply go to the debug menu of your app. Remember that this is still a test version, and will be improved once it is merged with the Play Store version, which contains other video optimizations that this version has not yet received. Now that you're familiar with NCE functionality, I'll share information about the games I tested, commenting on their behavior now compared to before the NCE project. Once the project is available on the Play Store, I plan to test about 50 games, and if you wish, I can even test on a Redmi Note 8 with only 4 GB of RAM. To start, I tested 2 games from the Naruto franchise. The first is Naruto Shippuden Ultimate Ninja Storm 4, which previously only ran in handheld mode. Now I can run it in docked mode, meaning with only 8 GB of RAM, the game runs in native full HD. Also, using docked mode significantly reduces aliasing, providing an excellent experience. The game maintains a constant 30 FPS without any variation throughout the recording. Although I haven't tested Naruto x Boruto Ultimate Ninja Storm connections yet because the game was released last week, in this NCE version, it runs perfectly in 1080p, which is impressive. Another game that had performance and audio issues in previous app versions was Need for Speed Hot Pursuit Remastered. It's worth noting that this game still doesn't have an alternative version for PC. Again, running the game in 1080p in docked mode, there was no FPS variation, remaining stable at 30 FPS. All lighting and sound issues were fixed, allowing you to now enjoy this game in the palm of your hands, wherever you are. Pokémon Legends Arceus, which previously became unplayable in about 10 minutes, with FPS dropping to 7 and causing device overheating, now runs normally. I recorded for about half an hour, from the early moments of the game to the city and the open field, managing to run the game on my device at 1080p and a steady 30 FPS. Astral Chain, one of the heaviest games on this system and also one of the most difficult to run outside of the Nintendo Switch, still does not show satisfactory results on my device, maintaining an average of 20 FPS. It should be noted that this game has many action moments where the compilation of various shaders simultaneously is required, and even lowering the resolution to 75%, the results are still below expectations. Dragon Ball FighterZ, another highly anticipated anime fighting game for Android, I managed to run it at 1080p in docked mode. However, I noticed a serious issue with this game, as the app still struggles to compile many shaders simultaneously, leading to freezing when executing certain special moves. I noticed that this happens more often in handheld mode than in docked mode. To play it successfully, several attempts will be needed until most shaders are completely compiled. What if I tell you I managed to run a game at 2160p? Would you believe it? That was the case with Donkey Kong Tropical Freeze. The background footage you're seeing was recorded in X2 resolution, docked mode reaching 2160p. Since updating the drivers to version 24, I noticed small problems with bubbles and other transparency effects, but the performance of a Nintendo Switch game running on Android at 2160p, at least for me, seemed impossible until now. For football lovers, we still don't have FC 24, but I managed to run FIFA 23. The game still has issues with some missing items, such as the marking indicating which athlete the player is currently controlling. The absence of some shadows was also noticed. NCE affects only 64-bit games, and in this case, Mario Kart 8 was developed in 32 bits, so it did not receive improvements. Some versions of Yuzu NCE broke the multiplayer mode, so if you can't run the game with more than one player, update your Yuzu version. Overall, this game performs worse in these early access versions, but the version available on the Play Store allows you to run the game in multiplayer mode and with a constant 60 FPS. Mega Man 11 is another game that I had tested before and had performance issues. Now, I can run it at 1080p steady at 60 FPS, and I didn't notice any graphical problems. Pokémon Scarlet also performs well in docked mode but suffers from various memory leaks and some minor vertex explosions. If you're waiting to play this game, it might be better to wait for the Play Store version to be updated. I also noticed that, using handheld mode, memory leaks are more common than in docked mode. Pokémon Sword is rendering correctly, and no problems were noticed. The game runs with plenty of room at 1080p, maybe even able to increase the resolution or unlock the FPS. Unlike Pokémon Scarlet, there were no memory leaks, not even in the DLC area, as it is a very extensive area. Another game that runs well is Skyrim. I watched gameplay from various locations, and it runs steady at 30 FPS. However, at least at the time of recording, there was memory leakage or breaks due to shaders being rendered simultaneously. I used version 135 to record this video, and at the time of the script, the current version is 138. Always use the latest version to avoid possible errors. Super Mario Odyssey, one of the best Nintendo Switch games, was able to run at almost 60 FPS in handheld mode. But I must warn you that when entering new areas for the first time, the app will likely crash, as it still can't handle many shaders simultaneously. However, the experience is now much smoother, without slowing down throughout the gameplay. The recently released Super Mario Wonder has also been improved and is now in excellent condition, managing to maintain almost 60 FPS all the time. Rendering issues on the level selection map no longer occur, and long gaming sessions no longer cause slowdowns. Another Dragon Ball franchise game I tested was XENOVERSE 2. I know this game is very popular on PC and has already been released for very affordable prices, but it has never come to Android. Even in the city, which is the largest and most populated environment, the game manages to stay at 30 FPS and 1080p on my device. Since this game's battle arenas are smaller, I believe performance will be even better. Lastly, we have one of the best Switch games, which many of you still want to play, the Zelda franchise games. Starting with Breath of the Wild, the game received many improvements. I can maintain gameplay above 26 FPS, causing GPU bottlenecks. I believe that with a Snapdragon Gen 2 processor, you will be able to stay at 30 FPS in most areas. Although it is not yet the ideal state, if you don't mind a bit of slowdown, you will be able to enjoy this game. And the heavyweight, Zelda Tears of the Kingdom, despite no longer having issues like excessive slowness, going into the open field is practically a mission impossible with a device with only 8 GB of RAM. At least this time, I managed to progress beyond the initial dungeon, where Link is with Zelda. However, when really entering the open world of the game, FPS drops drastically below 20, making the experience very unsatisfactory. Remember that the link to get the latest build will be in the description. And guys, please share this video in all Android communities. It took a lot of work to make it, and you practically won't find anyone on YouTube using capture cards on their devices to bring the video with this extreme quality, where you can really see the smallest details. Soon, I will test various games just to keep a Yuzu Android compatibility list. If you want to see the performance of the game you want to play, and it hasn't been posted here, leave a comment. Until the next video.